Harper and Harper Audio present Jayson Goes For It by Brayden Harrington with David Ritz, performed by Matt Pittenger. This book is dedicated to my family for always believing in me through good and bad times. B.H. To Miss Raisin, my seventh grade teacher who said, "Stuttering is nothing to be ashamed of." D.R. Chapter 1. I know my name. If there's one word I can say without stuttering, it's the word here. Here is the first word I've had to say in front of a full classroom on every first day of school since I was 7. In first grade, I could barely get it out.
It took a good 30 seconds in third grade, but by fifth grade, it was easy.
I can say here with perfect fluency. It's the one word I've been able to count on to get me past my speaking jitters, especially now that I'm in eighth grade at Bloom Middle School. But not this year. Nope. Miss Wolfson had to be different and change things up on me.
We're all supposed to say our names and something about ourselves to the whole homeroom class.
At least I don't have to go first.
I'm Chad Callahan. I like to play baseball and go fishing, which I did a lot of this summer.
Good to meet you, Chad. Next?
Miss Wolfson says. I practice my introduction in my head. The annoying thing is I almost always stutter on my name. Jayson Linden, I plan to say. My name is Jayson Linden, since I figure I'll have a better chance of not stuttering on the word my. Sometimes if I can get a flow going, I can avoid stuttering. That's something my speech therapist taught me. My friend Preeta is up next.
I'm Preeta Chandra. I play field hockey and do crafts with my grandmother.
I'm Seth Greenberg. I like baseball cards.
Thanks a lot, Seth. You can't like them that much or you would have had more to say about them. Why are everyone's introductions so short? Can't someone tell a story about something interesting they did over the summer? Why doesn't everyone have a lot more hobbies?
Oh, good. Samantha's next. She's chatty and talks a lot. She'll kill some time.
Hi, my name is Samantha Hodgkins, and I...
Samantha suddenly starts coughing loudly, choking on her own spit or something. She holds her hand up, and Miss Wolfson gives her a hall pass to go to the nurse.
Great.
The introductions only seem to go faster from here, and before I know it, Miss Wolfson's looking at me.
My name is Jayson Linden.
Oops, that was in my head. She's still looking at me.
Jayson, would you like to introduce yourself?
I stand up. Maybe I should fake a coughing fit so I can be excused like Samantha. My heart is beating fast. I really don't want to stutter. I would love to start out the year fooling everyone. By being anyone other than the kid who stutters. I get stuck on the my. My trick doesn't work, which frustrates me even more. I stutter on every word, and I can feel my normally pale face flash red hot. It takes nearly half a minute for me to say, my name
is...
I can't even get the first consonant sound out. One of my classmates in the front row laughs and says,
"Did you forget your name?"
There's always someone who feels the need to say something mean. This time it's Chad. Everyone starts cracking up. I'm rattled, but I try to stick it out anyway.
J.
And just when I think I'm going to make it through my name, Miss Wolfson interrupts me.
It's okay, Jayson.
It's my biggest pet peeve. You think you hate getting interrupted? Try on a stutter for a few days and see if you don't hate it 10 times more. To my surprise, a voice pipes up behind me.
Let him finish.
I turn around to look at the kid who spoke up. A girl I've never seen before is giving me a warm smile. She must be a new student. Is she making fun of me? No, I don't think so. I can tell when someone is mocking me. People aren't very good about faking a stutter because they don't know how it feels. Even though I've never met another stutterer, she seems to be the real deal. Miss Wolfson nods and purses her lips as if to restrain herself from interrupting again. She nods at me to keep going, and I finally get my full name out. But I don't bother with anything else. When I sit down, the new girl stands up. She doesn't look the least bit worried about taking her turn. In fact, she seems cooler than a lot of the non-stutterers in my class.
My name is Gloria Lopez. My family moved here at the beginning of the summer. I like debate, and I'm not afraid of controversy.
Actually, I like controversy. Actually, I love it. The more controversial, the happier I am.
People laugh, but not because she stutters, because she's funny. When she's finished, she tosses her dark, shiny hair over her shoulder with a smirk and sits back down.
She catches me looking at her and gives me a wink.
The next kid speaks.
I'm Gino Roboto. I like to play soccer.
There are a few students left to give their introductions, but I barely hear them.
Who is this new girl, Gloria Lopez? I want to get to know her better.
Chapter 2.
Hoop.
I can't stop thinking about Gloria the rest of the school day. I wanted to introduce myself to her one-on-one after homeroom, but she left the classroom pretty quickly once the bell rang. I kept hoping to see her face in one of my other classes, but unfortunately, we don't have any other classes together. Maybe tomorrow I'll get to homeroom early so I can talk to her. The last bell rings, and I head to the locker room to change into my clothes for basketball practice. It's about to be the best part of my day because, one, I don't have to talk much, just play, and two, I get to hang with my best friend, Chuck. Chuck has a great sense of humor, and we've always gotten along. We've played basketball together ever since we were little kids, and we've been on the same teams together almost as long.
He's one of not that many black kids in our school. Once I've changed into my basketball clothes, I run into the gym where I see Chuck practicing his jump shot.
Hey, Chuck,
I say, grabbing my own basketball from the ball rack.
Hey, Jayson, how was your first day?
Pretty good. Just then, I notice Mac Gaines walking into the gym. Mac's the best athlete at school. Mac's about my height. Although he was eager to point out that he's got a half inch on me before school let out for summer. He gloats about everything and has been competitive with me ever since he moved here in the sixth grade when I beat him out for the highest GPA in the class. He's super popular, he has good grades, and is always a starter as a power forward. Everyone seems to like him, plus his dad is our town's mayor. I even once saw my favorite basketball player, Steph Curry, high-five Mac on ESPN when he was sitting courtside at the Warriors-Celtics game, and I was so jealous. Mac runs up to us.
Can you dunk?
He asks me right before he does.
I've been trying?
Mac fills in for me, bouncing the basketball up and down.
Let him finish his own sentence,
Chuck snaps, moving to slap the ball away from Mac.
I don't have time to wait. Mac shrugs, dodging Chuck. He dribbles, hits a layup, and runs over to talk to Coach Croft. Mac gets on my nerves, but he and Chuck really don't get along. Chuck thinks Mac is stuck up, and he's not afraid to tell him so. I wish I was better at telling Mac when he's being rude. Coach Croft blows his whistle and starts running us through passing drills before dividing us into teams to practice running plays.
Geez, Gaines, is anyone going to shoot but you?
Chuck shouts as Mac sinks a three-pointer instead of passing to Chuck or me when we're both wide open.
The person who's most likely to score is the one who should be shooting,
Mac smirks.
Cute. I suppose the rest of us should just quit so you can be the team on your own,
I snap.
Lighten up, Jayson. It's just practice.
I don't say anything else because I'm angry. And when I get mad, my fluency goes out the window. He's right. The stakes aren't high. We're just getting ready for tryouts. But then Mac decides to go straight to the basket instead of passing to me or Chuck again.
This is ridiculous,
says Chuck, throwing his hands up in the air. Hey, Chuck, it's no big deal,
Max says, holding his palms out in a gesture of surrender.
That's a signature Mac move. He makes the other person look like a hothead by shrugging off his own jerkiness like it's just a joke. I can't stand that.
Gentlemen, enough, says Coach Croft, finally stepping in. Let's all get along, please. Remember, you're on the same team.
For some reason, Croft calls us gentlemen, as if we're all wearing fancy tuxedos instead of a bunch of dudes making fart noises with their armpits.
Chuck takes a deep breath, but that isn't the end of it. During the next drill, Mac knocks Chuck over with his shoulder on the way to the basket. And that's that. Chuck springs up from the floor and runs toward Mac, who's sneering smugly. Suddenly, Coach is between them. Honestly, I didn't know he could still move that fast.
Neville, go home and cool off, he says.
Yeah, all right, I guess it's me, says Chuck, and he walks off the court.
Coach, that's not...
I don't want to hear it's not fair, Jayson. You want to be next?
Now, if there's one thing I can't stand, it's when people assume they know what I'm going to say. Usually, they're not even right. This one time, though, Coach had understood me just fine. It wasn't fair.
Chapter 3. Regrouping at Rockin' Bowl. Chuck's home is on top of Rockin' Bowl, the bowling alley in the same strip mall as our town's Rite Aid and Ace Hardware. It's right next to the barbershop where Dad and I get our haircuts. Even if Chuck weren't my best friend, I would probably still hang out with him for Rockin' Bowl. It's our second favorite place in town after the basketball court. The best part is the collection of vintage pinball machines. We're allowed to play them for free anytime we want, since Chuck's dad, Mr. Neville, owns the bowling alley. Rockin' Bowl is a good place to relax and blow off steam, which is exactly what we do after the first day's tense basketball practice. We head over to our favorite machine, Mars Attack. Chuck goes first and scores 150,000 points. The scores are ridiculous in pinball. I figure I'm done for, but the pinball forces are with me today as I rack up points on my turn. 100,000, then 200,000, then 300,000. Watch out! I'm about to take over the universe, I yell gleefully, hitting the pinball controllers.
Jeez, I forget how fluent you get when you're talking trash, Chuck says with a laugh.
I lost my final ball at 325,000.
And that's that. Bye-bye, Earthlings. You had a good run.
Not bad, but you still didn't beat Dad's high score of 500,000.
Save it for another day.
Let's go eat.
I'm supposed to see my speech therapist, Dr. Dan, at 4. His office is about a 20-minute walk from Rockin' Bowl. But I'm hungry and tired, and today has already been challenging enough between first day of school nerves and basketball practice. A burger takes priority, so we go downstairs to see Big Al, who runs the restaurant inside Rockin' Bowl. He is as good at making burgers as he is at horse, which is saying a lot.
The usual, Jayson?
Asks Big Al.
Yes, please. Thank you.
There's almost nothing I'd rather have than one of Al's burgers. The cheese oozes out the sides when you take a bite, and the burger is always super juicy. Al also has this special secret sauce that is creamy and tangy with just a little bit of spice. It's perfection. And he always throws in some extra fries. It's early for dinner, and people have started to wander into bowl. The pop and rumble sounds of the bowling alley are soothing to me. I've all but forgotten about the cruddy day I've had. But as we're eating, Chuck asks,
So how'd the rest of practice go without me?
I swallow my bite of burger and wipe the sauce off my face.
Should have just left with you, I say.
Why?
I just hate looking at Mac's smug face.
Well, you have to do that anyway, he says.
Yeah, I say, but it seems worse when you're not there, and I don't like how Coach Croft handled it.
Dude's always been easy on Mac. He's probably scared of what Mac might tell Mayor Gaines.
Being the mayor's son sure has its privileges,
I say.
Yeah, but it means you're always the mayor's son. Mac will never know who he is or what he's capable of on his own.
I guess that's true.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.